Do people make tier list videos anymore? I felt like I was behind the times when I was making them in 2019, but people seem to like them, so if I'm posting cringe right now, let's just blame it on the algorithm for favoring these videos, okay? Hey everyone, thank you so much for 400,000 subscribers. I thought a fun way to celebrate the milestone would be to have a look back at some of the content I've made over the last 4 years. Now, this list won't primarily be about videos of mine that are best in terms of writing or editing or performance, because I think that's really up to you guys to decide, not me. I'll discuss some of those things, but this tier list will have more to do with videos that have served as learning experiences, which have affected the course of my channel. Also, I can't cover all the videos I've made here, there are just too many, so I'm only going to discuss a handful. That said, let's get to it. In F tier, I've got to place my one and only video I've ever done on genetically modified organisms reacting to anti-GMO propaganda.
Hey, look, my genetically modified fruit bit me back. Frankenfoods are fun foods.
Oh God, no. What? Oh God, yeah, it's pretty painful. I'm not gonna lie. That's hard to watch. I posted this video when my channel was a week old, and I really didn't know how to talk to the camera. I felt so awkward doing it that I think it comes across pretty clearly in the video. I also didn't script anything in my first few videos, which definitely didn't help me get my points across. This video is embarrassing, but I haven't deleted it because I don't want people to mistakenly think that I've been competent in making videos from the start. When I started, I used a phone for a camera, I used a window for lighting, and I only had the most basic grasp on video editing, plus I obviously had no clue how to speak on camera. Not everyone is even privileged enough to be in that situation, but I hope that when people look back on my earliest videos, they'll see that everyone just has to start somewhere in speaking on issues they're passionate about. So if you have a story or perspective to share, if you'd like to start a channel or something like that, realize that it's okay to learn as you go. It's better to get off to an imperfect start than to refuse to start for fear of being imperfect. This video, I am placing in F tier. For D tier, we're fast forwarding to my video on Gaia, the streaming service. This was another of my largely unscripted videos. Because this streaming service profiteers off of spreading unsourced, dangerous misinformation about science, medicine, history, politics, and basically all other topics that they discuss, I used a lot of mockery in this one, which is pretty different from my usual approach.
Is it just me, or does this sound like the Flying Dutchman from SpongeBob?
It looked like a ghostly ship as it would slowly come down. It would look like a solid pirate ship.
I don't think it was inappropriate to use mockery, but I don't think it got my points across very well. Most of my actual points were made near the end of the video, and anyone partial to Gaia's content probably tuned me out long before then. I also used the word woke in this video to refer to believing in Alex Jones-style conspiracy theories, because that's just honestly what I thought it meant. Only later did I learn that it more commonly has to do with social justice issues. So, yeah. Not a good look. I think that they're really trying to appeal to woke people. The upside to this video is that it prompted a viewer to make this meme template, which is pretty much just the Drake meme, but for conspiracy theories. Someone also made a GIF out of this clip, which I found entertaining. I haven't made many videos like this one because while they're easy to make and can be pretty entertaining, they don't facilitate my points very well. I found it more effective to disarm potential critics with a more even-handed approach than to lead with mockery, even if what I'm mocking definitely deserves it. This one lands in D tier. On to C tier. Here, I'm placing my documentary-style videos in Israel and Palestine. I don't put these in C tier because I think they're bad. I put them here as a reflection of my view of my own role in their production. They're still good videos, I had a blast working on them, and I learned a lot through the experience. That said, my planning of these videos was very rushed, and I had no experience producing long-form documentary-style content. If it weren't for my friend Jeremy, who is an excellent videographer and producer, these wouldn't have come together at all. He filmed all of these, edited the two from Israel, and I edited the one in Palestine. I cannot thank Jeremy enough for the ridiculous amount of work he did to make these videos happen. I'd still like to produce long-form documentary-style content in the future, but next time, I'd personally like to have more of a plan from the beginning. My favorite thing to come out of these videos is my friendship with all of those involved. I'd especially like to shout out Amir, the co-host of my videos in Israel. Shortly after these videos were filmed, I came down with such severe bacterial pneumonia that I was basically bedridden for 5 days in a hostel in Tel Aviv, with no way to get food for myself. Like, I couldn't even walk, right? I reached out to my brand new friend, Amir, and he immediately brought me homemade soup, went out and got me medicine, and then he took care of me every day until I went home. So, Amir, you're an amazing friend, and I cannot wait to see you again once we can travel internationally. These are still very informative and worthwhile videos, but that isn't thanks to me. Jeremy and Amir are the ones who really pulled these off. It's incredible that I was given the opportunity to work on projects like this, and now that I have a bit of experience, I hope to bring a little more to the table next time. Given that the part I played in these videos was just okay, I'm placing them in C tier. Okay, in B tier, we have a few videos which all have a similar premise, criticizing ideas from within my own tribe. These videos are 4 Things Atheists Should Never Say and its sequel, as well as 4 Things Atheists Get Wrong When Criticizing Christianity. The fallout from these videos was less than I expected, but I did lose hundreds of subscribers with each of them, and got some pretty nasty comments and messages. That's just YouTube, so I wasn't upset by that, but it did have me thinking that if there are atheists out there who are that averse to constructive criticism, such criticism is all the more necessary. I did receive a lot of kind, encouraging messages after posting each of these 2, even from people who didn't entirely agree with what I had said. Being a YouTuber, you naturally receive a lot of criticism, and it can be hard to know what you should consider versus what you should just ignore. The interactions I had with my audience following these videos greatly helped me develop a better sense about that, as so many of you showed me what it looks like to both give and take constructive criticism in this medium. I came away from most interactions surrounding these videos proud to have so many in my audience who are willing to have challenging but rewarding conversations in good faith. Next up, A tier. Here we have Why Theists Can't Convert Atheists and 4 Mistakes Theists Make When Trying to Convert Atheists. These videos convey the most important point I think I've ever made about the discourse between Abrahamic theists, mainly Christians and Muslims, and atheists. The number one reason many of these theists can't convert atheists is that they very often refuse to set their assumptions about atheists aside and actually listen. Hilariously, the majority of critical comments I've gotten on these videos just prove that point. Comments like, "Oh, you say I can't convert you, huh? Well, let me tell you about this argument that you've never heard. It's called Pascal's Wager." Or, "I watched the first minute of this video and it's already clear to me that you just left Christianity because you want to sin." On the other hand, though, I've had many theists comment to say, "I came here to criticize the video, but then I watched it and thought you're probably right." Or, "This is a great reminder that we should approach these discussions in love, and listening is a part of that." Or even something like, "I'm a Christian, but I think these are important points, so I'll be sharing them with my Bible study group." Those comments mean the world to me, and I hope to influence my audience to show that kind of empathy too. In my public and private life, this call for listening without assumptions has become a bit of a personal mantra. It's aided me in personal relationships, and it's even been a major point of discussion between myself and a few Christian leaders. Sean McDowell and I discussed it in our recent conversation on his channel, for example. In all of those interactions, I've found that if someone is willing to take a step back, acknowledge the assumptions they're bringing in, put those aside, and then listen, conversing with them is worthwhile. If they're not willing to do that, it's best to just save my breath and move on. Finally, we're at S tier. Here I'm placing the cult I almost joined, Young Living Essential Oils. This is one of the most important videos on my channel for me. My own investigation into the multi-level marketing scheme Young Living was massively transformative for my wife and I, as it taught us why skepticism is a necessity for anyone who wants to defend themselves from the manipulation and abuse of entities who will take advantage of the impressionable for money. My life could have gone a very different direction had we joined that company, and I definitely think we chose the better road. Sometime after the video came out, I learned that one of the founders, as well as the CEO of Young Living, had seen the video. Young Living then threatened me with legal action if I didn't take the video down. I thought, for what? Slander? For discussing real police reports and news stories about Gary Young's known criminal history? Copyright infringement for using Young Living's clips in a transformative way for commentary? They backed down when I refused to remove the video. It just goes to show how desperate they are to silence critics. You know, kind of like a cult. In S tier, I'm also placing Creationist Kent Hovind challenges me, I respond. Like I say in the video, Kent Hovind was a kind of hero of mine when I was a teenager. Seeing him respond to me as he did was surreal. Even though he obviously didn't take responding to me any more seriously than any other cheap attempt at getting views, it was significant to me. He tried to make me feel small, but the fact that my former hero even knew my name made me realize how far my voice had actually reached. Realizing that had an impact on me, and it molded my perspective on what a constructive response would look like. This video was a bit of a turning point for my channel. I could have responded with anger and turned this into a monetizable response war with Hovind, but that runs counter to the goals of this channel. At the beginning of 2020, I was becoming concerned with the growth of my channel. Not that I was concerned it wasn't growing, but really the opposite. It was growing larger than I'd ever intended, and I realized that the more influence I have, the more careful I need to be with my influence. People will repeat the things I say in my videos and will mirror the tone I take in my responses, so I should be sure that my words and tone are focused on making this discourse better. I can't control how my words are used beyond me, but it's only responsible that I recognize that my words will be used beyond me and to craft them accordingly. The reflections this video prompted have stayed with me since, and I'd like to share some of them in reference to passing my recent milestone. I never intended or even dreamed of having the size of following that I do now. Because my following is growing as it is, I realize that I need to be even more careful about setting a good example and being responsible with my words than ever before. I have failed to set a good example before, and I'll almost definitely fail again in the future, but I will try my best going forward. One of the reasons I put out videos more slowly these days is that I want to ensure now more than ever that every release is beneficial to this discourse, stays true to the channel's original goals, and is made in full acknowledgement of the responsibilities that come with my platform. After all, do I want to be the atheist version of Kent Hovind, just stoking outrage for financial gain and refusing to take responsibility for my own failures? Or do I want to do better? My goals on this channel have been to encourage critical thinking, to speak up for atheists and apostates who can't speak up because of their own circumstances, to normalize atheism and leaving one's faith, and to implore those on all sides of the issues I discuss to engage with empathy. While there's much more work to be done, I want to thank all of you who've given me constructive criticism, suggestions, encouragement, and support thus far. I wouldn't be here without you, so thank you. Thanks for watching. I've been Drew of Genetically Modified Skeptic. A special thanks to my patrons for their constant love and support. If you want to hear more from me, subscribe and follow me on social media at the handles below. As always, if you're an apostate in need, there are resources linked in the description to help you find community and mental health support. Remember to be kind to others in the comments, and until next time, stay skeptical.